What's up, YouTube? Tim Muriello, fitness and supplement expert for I'llPumpYouUp.com, your favorite online supplement store. Today, I wanted to cover a topic, a subject about teenage bodybuilding. Now, I'm an NPC competitor. I've been competing for a very long time. I've done 20 bodybuilding contests. And I would say probably about 10 of those were as a teenager. I did a lot of teenage bodybuilding competitions. I did a lot of teenage powerlifting competitions as well. I did, I think, like Mr. Florida 3 years in a row, Mr. Tampa Bay 4 years in a row, a lot of other contests. So I got a lot of experience in teenage bodybuilding, and to be honest with you, I've got just a heart for teenage bodybuilders in general. Teenagers are very focused on bodybuilding once they get bit by what they call the iron bug, I guess you could say. Very, very focused. I mean, they'll put their heart into it, and some of them that are very dedicated, and they won't stop, man. They'll just keep going and going and going. And so I wanted today to cover just teenage bodybuilding in general, offer some tips about teenage bodybuilding, and just give some encouragement to some teenagers out there trying to make it happen, trying to put some muscle on, and those that have dreams of going big. Now, teenage bodybuilding is going to be probably the best years of your life for growth as a bodybuilder, okay? When you're a teenager, you just have so many hormones going through your system at such high levels. Dude, your test levels are high, testosterone. Your growth hormone levels are high. All those hormones are so high, you're just going through such development and growth at that stage that it is the best times of your life to capitalize in bodybuilding on growth and gaining strength. Matter of fact, when I was a teenager, I did so many bodybuilding contests that I won a lot of trophies. I did very well. It was a huge learning experience. But, you know, part of me almost wishes that I didn't do so many contests. Part of me wishes that I didn't diet and spend all those years of dieting. And instead of dieting, I should have just been bulking up a lot more. But, you know, hard to say, you know. Again, winning all those trophies, you know how it is when you were a teenager, or if you're a teenager now, when you win that trophy, I mean, there's nothing like it. When you get on stage and you do well and you get that trophy, you bring that trophy home, it's just a very, very good feeling. Your family's out in the audience, and you know, your friends, and they're cheering you on, and you come out the victor, the champion, because you worked hard and you put your heart and soul into it. One thing I want to tell you though, to be a successful teenage bodybuilder, you gotta make sacrifices, man. You gotta stay away from cigarettes, you gotta stay away from drinking, you gotta, sometimes, man, you gotta skip some parties because you gotta spend time in the gym. There's sometimes you gotta put the birthday cake away and the pizza away and trade those in for steaks, chicken breasts, and protein powder. That's just how it is. To be a successful teenage bodybuilder, to get to the next level, you really do have to make some sacrifices. There's many times as a teenager that I didn't partake in some things that maybe I should have or could have, but I didn't want to because I wanted that success. I tasted it and I wanted more of it. Now, as a teenage bodybuilder, like I said earlier, you have really high testosterone, very high human growth hormone flowing through your system. And I get so, oh my gosh, I get so many emails from teenagers asking me about, they'll ask me about steroids and pro hormones and test boosters. Should I take them? My answer is no. You already have so much going through your system. You don't need any more. You don't need the adverse side effects of those things right now because you make enough. You have enough. Capitalize on it. Be smart about it. Now, I will tell you this. Man, when you're teenage years and you're competing, it's good, man. It's an equal playing field. You got 16-year-olds, 17-year-olds, 18-year-olds, 19-year-olds, okay? But for me, one of the hardest things about teenage bodybuilding is when I turned 20. 2-0. Oh my gosh. I wish they had why don't they have a junior division in these bodybuilding contests? Why don't they have like a, you know, 20 to 23 year old division that you can kind of transition and ease into? It wasn't like that. I stepped from the teenage scene doing so well right into the bottom level of bodybuilding at 20 years old. I remember I was 20 years old. I competed against this dude who was 34 years old. He was 14 years older than me. Dude was way bigger and shredded. It was really hard for me to beat this guy. So, some advice, men, get a head start now while you're a teenager. Get a head start so when you get in your 20s, you're still competitive and you're winning trophies. Lastly, I just want to tell you guys, teenagers out there, train hard, man. Eat like crazy. Don't forget your macros, your protein, your carbs, your healthy fat. Do some research, learn new techniques, follow the bodybuilders, see what they're doing. Stay balanced in your life. Do your bodybuilding, make sure you have family time. You're sticking with your schoolwork and football and all that stuff, whatever sport else that you're involved in. And lastly, make sure to get that head start as a teenager, all right? Capitalize on those teenage years. That's my word for the teenagers. Listen, guys, thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll talk to you next time. Young Chop on the beat.